Okay.
So I have been doing a database of going to all the projects that have emerged around the hacker, Huracan hacker, and looking to the typology of project in the sense of who was promoting it. For example, there are cases in which there is just citizens, like people just start promoting to building a map, or there is Huffington Post, or there is a local newspaper, there is like different, or there is a local government also. So there is different type of promoters of crowdsourcing tools. So I have been looking to the type of promoter, also the type of technology, if it's a tool that is being just developed, or it's just a tool that was there and people just start using it, and looking about if actually it has been used, and how many contributions there has been. So in order to see, also looking which was the territorial scope of the project. My sense it was also that local projects tend to be more used. So I have been like collecting characteristics of the projects that has been put in place in order to crowdsource help on around Sandy, and looking about how these characteristics are can explain that they are being used or not, and how they are being used.
There are some, there are some lessons that you have learned that we can, or not yet.
So I think there is a very big gap between the projects that are not used at all and the projects that are used a little bit. And my sense is that the projects that tend to be used are the ones which are a lot around them. Like they are connected to, for example, this local newspaper that it's not that just they just started this project, if they have already like a community of readers, or there is already like a existing relationship community, and that then they focus their attention about building this tool, and contributing to this tool. So, like tools within existing networks tend to generate participation. Just tools there without thinking how to insert in previous networks of relationships are much more difficult to be used. I have also seen that generally there is a push to like at the beginning the contributions are like one person contributing a lot, and then suddenly other people is also contributing. There is a diversity of contributions. And I was also curious, like this Google Crisis Sandy map, that is actually not crowdsourcing. It's just Google that has this map and produce the data and just give you the map. But there is no possibility to actually intervene, which I find, I don't know why, I find very kind of...
The crisis map from Google.
Yeah, that org. It has a lot of visibility, then I have, I know Google has looked for volunteers in order to provide the data, but the data online is actually closed. You cannot participate. There is only like a possibility to send some feedback, but
I was actually surprised about that, because some of the sources for the data, especially some of the FEMA-related data, is actually from what they call HCIP Gold, which actually nobody except federal users have access to. So I don't know how they actually got that and then publicly displayed it on the map. It's all closed source data that they have access to, I guess. Mm-hmm.
Yes, so I think it's an experience reflector. I have also identified the different typologies of crowdsourcing. Like crowdsourcing understood as, okay, like there is this map or there is this kind of common pool in which people contribute. This is one type of crowdsourcing. Another type of crowdsourcing is when it's about sharing. It's not about building a common pool, but if I, like this example would be Instacame. Instacase, is you use the same tag, and so you generate, as a second element, you generate like a pool of pictures. But it's not that you have like a common URL and you're contributing, but it's that as the, in the way in which you share your actions, it results into a common resource. But the building of the common resource is not the primary building action. And another typology of crowdsourcing is this kind of matching needs. That is not about building a common resource, that is like a knowledge resource, it's about like putting people in contact. This would be like the third typology of crowdsourcing
I have identified. Yeah, because in your spreadsheet you are classifying projects by promoter and by the type of thing that people are submitting.
Yes, I am classifying about type of promoter, type of technology, and type of contribution. So and typology of what these people doing together, and also typology of how much it has been actually used or how many contributions there have been. The maximum I have found out is 228 contributions.
I mean, a lot. A lot of them are using. CrowdMap.
Yes.
It's like the instance of Usahiri, which is great. So people are relying on. They are not like making technically new deployment, but they're using some other, which is, I think, is great. But. And so you will write something about this, like a small.
Yes. So I have not finished the database in the sense of there are still. Projects I have not gone through, so I want to finish, and then I will publish a report or a post about what I have.
Yes.
What I think, just let me finish with this. So I am from Spain. My country is in a huge crisis, economic crisis. So I am wondering how this Sandy crisis we can learn how we are helping each other. In order to help each other, it's also for the economic level. This is my point.
Okay.
May I ask where are you from in Spain?
I'm from Valencia.
I would like to ask, not regarding Spain, which is also interests me particularly, but about, because a lot of the projects have this in common, because you were talking, the projects that are more successful are the ones that are connecting with existing networks.
Mm-hmm.
I don't try to create their own network, so I think it's a thing we have to have in account for other hackathons, to have always a community that we are working with and not trying to create a new community.
And there are two types of existing networks. Like one is about news, local news, for example. Another one is about previous disasters. There are two tools that actually emerged from groups that were in Irene, or in Colorado fire.
Yes.
Like in previous. So, and also through the networks of Occupy Wall Street.
Okay.